I'm the Punisher. I'm whooping ass, fucking everybody. I'm fucking.
I mean, one thing is that when me and Shauna here were starting to get like starting out kind of thing, and especially moving in and all this other stuff. I'm not saying if it's anywhere close to similar, but I mean, we're both very independent people and have taken a lot of pride on that. Mm. And
yep.
One of the things, I'm not sure if it's a similar thing or not, but it's really kind of hard asking for help or saying even like you even get to like almost feeling guilty for saying that you get a chance to relax. Could that be some part of that where it's like, I mean, I can't imagine having two kids on my own and being mostly independent and then, I mean, just the same thing. And then
and being them told, like,
then actually starting to have help down. With it.
Yeah.
And then not being able to work.
And now you're starting to feel, because what I'm getting out of it too, and this is just what how I would feel in that sense, is I'm one of those people who I'm independent. You can ask Matt any day. You can ask Panda any day of the week. I am solo dolo. I am I'm independent lady, Beyonce, single ladies, pachanza. Okay.
And if you like to put a ring on it. Yeah, okay.
But I would have felt like, yeah, I mean, personally, if somebody told me, okay, you can relax, it's like, oh, okay, until when? Because I got to work. I need to bring in money. I need to do what I need to do. I need to take care of this. I've been doing it my whole entire life. And now all of a sudden, you know, just because you come in with your nice little income, but, you know, I'm still going to want to work because I still got to do this because ain't nobody going to feed my mouth but me. You know what I mean? Well, still got that mentality.
But at some point, so, you know, this is what I'm firm believing. So at some point, you gotta get out the driver's seat. Now, I'm not saying that a woman shouldn't be able to say this is what I'm gonna do and stand on her own too and do what she gotta do for herself or her kids. But what I'm saying is that at some point, I know that I'm gonna need to get my ass out the driver's seat and sit in the passenger seat, and I'm all for that. Mm-hmm. You gotta be able to know when to drive and when not to drive.
Share it.
We can't be always pulling up to the party in different cars. Like, you know what I'm saying? The car, all right, by the time we get there, mindset is different. Conversation is different. Because whatever I experienced or whatever I seen on the right there and whatever you experienced or whatever you seen on the right there is going to give you a different outlook on life. So that's why we both got to be in the same car and we got to know when to get out that driver's seat. And like I said, that, you know, I'm not going to be in a position all the time to where I can say, sit your ass at the house. It's gonna be a time where you need to get your ass up and run. Like, you know what I'm saying? I need
that's
to sit
why
my
you
ass
gotta
at the house.
You gotta stay ready. If you stay ready, you never gotta get
yeah,
ready.
Of course.
And as a woman, as a black woman at that, I'm sorry you went there. You I mean you had you have gotta go there.
Gotta go.
I'm just it's saying that telling a strong woman to sit back is like calling her a B word.
In my
opinion. Because I feel like you're saying I can't handle this.
No.
And we can handle it.
No, it's not so much as handling. It's so much as just saying that, look, you married me for a reason. You married me because you wanted my help. And I want your help. Yeah, and trust my help. It's not
just. Why can't it just be because of love?
No. What I'm saying is that's a part of love. A part of love is support and understanding. If I support and understand what you're doing, cool, I got you. It's never to say that I don't think you shouldn't have your own by any means. Do what you got to do. I'm happy for you. I don't want to tear you down. But if there's a time where if anything happens where you need, well, like for instance, my wife, she had a situation at her job and she had to sit down for a second. Babe, sit down. We not. Don't rush. Like I always tell her, don't rush to just jump in jobs that you're going to later regret. Like, go to school, figure it out, put it together. So when you do go back to work, you're doing something that you want to do. And then I can sit down and do something I want to do to where it's easier for the both of us. I want you to be prosperous as possible. I want to be able to say, if I die, leave this earth, you're straight. And it's not because I'm giving you proceeds because of my death. It's because of the work and time you put in because you took the time to figure out what you want to do. It's not always going to be like that. There's a gang of moms or single moms out there that never really pursued their dream because they never had nobody tell them, like, look, let me hold this down for you. You go to school, take care of what you got to take care of. Then double back. You back with you in your field. You moving and grooving. You doing you. Now I can kind of sit back and like, okay, now it's time for me to strike on something. Strike on my thing. Get my thing going, moving and grooving. Now we equally yoked because we both doing something we love. It's not like job after job after job. When you get in that cycle of jobs, and trust me, my wife don't have so many jobs because she never really took the time to focus on one thing that she wanted to do. Go to school, babe. She go to school. As soon as she go to school, what she want to do? Go get a job. And then when she gets the job, she start lacking in school. I ain't gonna be able to make it through this class. Babe, I told you, take your time to do that. You're like one class away. Take your time. Don't rush. I got this. Chill. Don't worry about none of that. I got this. Because whatever you're going to do is going to help me out in the long run. You know what I'm saying? You want to open your daycare? You got one more class? Do that. You're going to be straight. You'll be making money. I'll help you with that. Now it's time for me to double back. All right. Let me see what I need to do. Let me move on something now. Okay. Boom. I'm straight. Wifey making her money. I can move on this real quick. Move on that. Double up. We both good. We both moving. Now we teaching our kids how to work with each other, how to hold it down. And I'm honestly say, like, with my oldest right now, I am, like, extremely proud of this girl. Like, this girl got a job, right? And to be like what I was telling her mom, like, you know, don't stress about no bills or nothing. Let her get her money. Let her stack her money. This girl, every day, on our heads, yo, I got to be at work. Hey, 20 minutes. I got to be there. Come on. Like, I'm just looking at her like, motherfucker, it's my car. like, I gotta go. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I see her mom in her like that. But that's what made me realize. And I be telling her, like, look, you know what I'm saying? Don't fuck up, you know, a future for yourself because you focused on trying to make money now. And that's the same shit her mom does. Same shit. Slow down. Get it together. We'll double back. You get that going? Now it's my turn. Now I can double up and do what I got to do. Now we both equally yoked. We're, that's what you call a power couple. Hell, Jay-Z even know, okay, when Beyonce doing her album, let her do her album, I got the kids. When I'm on my shit, hey, you know what I'm saying? Let me do my album shit. Then we both drop something together, put it together, whatever. You know what I'm saying? It has to be like that.
I feel like that, too. It should be, you know, hand in hand. Like, you know, in a way, a man should help the woman should help the man, you know, and it could be two different ways, you know, like for a man to provide, if he has the, you know, opportunity to provide, he makes the money and the woman is at the house, you know, she could be doing stuff around the house, making sure the kids are straight, you know, everything is good at the house. And if she wants to go out and work or do whatever she want, you know, I wouldn't hold her back. You know what I'm saying? To do what she want to do. You know what I'm saying? That's just me. You know, I wouldn't hold her back if that's something she wants to do. You know, I would provide for it, you know what I'm saying, to where she can, you know, kind of have a balance to where I'm working, I'm providing, and, you know, you handling things at the house, you know, cooking, cleaning, you know, the kids are straight, everything is good like that, you know. But if you want that opportunity to go out and get yourself a job or do whatever, you know, I'm not gonna hold you to it. You know what I'm saying? You know, you're more than welcome to do that too. You know what I'm saying? But you know, it long as it's, you know, 50-50 and you know, yeah. You know, I think that's what's the key in a relationship. You know, everyone got to be on the same page for the most part.
And I think that with that, I'm gonna go along with what you're saying. I mean, I'm hearing a lot of staying at home, taking care of the kids.
I didn't say take care of the kids.
I'm just saying I heard on this side. Oh. Okay, I heard on your side.
What I'm saying is sit down is more saying like focus on what you want to do. Stop trying to focus on now. Let me take care of now. You worry about the future. I got now.
He was saying a lot of things. Like for the most part, it's like decide on what you want and then we'll figure it out.
It's just, you guys, you got to understand respect, okay?
Oh, yeah, I respect my wife.
I'm not saying, oh. No one disrespects anybody on that end. I'm sure everybody respects all of their loved ones. Awesome. I'm saying the respect of the grind, okay? Yeah. I mean, what I'm hearing is, a lot of, you know, I wish you would do the opposite of what she's doing now and not more of praising, like, okay, but she's a go-getter. I respect that about her. I respect that she's not sitting around. you know, just popping out babies and sitting there waiting for you to come home with nothing, to, you know, no food.
She couldn't pop out babies like that because I don't think I produce kids like that. I only got two.
Either way, you know, she's handling business and just respect it. Just, you know, just, I mean, like, I get it. You know, you guys have your ideal of what you wanted the woman of your life to do for you, but just respect that she's still a woman. She's still someone, a human being with a mind, with goals. And even though she may have a million goals to do this job, do that, or what have you, you know, she's still that time, that brain is still ticking, and she's still motivated to move forward. She's not just sitting there and she's collecting checks from you.
No, right? I never said sit there and collect a check. I'm saying if you want to pursue other things, this is the opportunity to do, because I might not be always able in this position to do it. Like, if I'm saying, babe, you want to finish your school? Finish your school. That's all you got to worry about. Go to school and finish. Graduate and get home.
I would say it does, like I was saying before, it does have to have a balance, because if you have kids, you have to put that in effect too. If you have kids, there has to be somebody at the house, you know, making sure the kids are straight. You know what I mean? Like, you can't, if both of y'all working and everybody's neglecting the kids, what do the kids have? You know what I mean? So you have to put that in effect too. Now, if it's just you and you don't have no kids, then it's a different story. You know what I mean? Like, hey, you know, both parties could work. You know what I mean? It should, you know, it's what, you know, I feel like, you know, long as you guys are on the same page and you guys are pushing together, that's all that matters.